You and Rick both.
Oh my.
Mm-hmm.
We don't smell like hockey.
Well, Zadie pooped her pants up the back, so I figured instead of throwing them in alone.
Don't even.
Why? It got washed. She's just a baby.
Pooping her poop clothes with my sheets.
I did it on an extra rinse.
Oh my god.
So both of your beds are all made.
Awesome.
And Annie dusted in Ricky's room. Oh my god, she started with Windex and ruined the corner of the desk. I was like, no, you can't spray Windex on cherry wood.
Uh-oh.
But his room's all straightened up. Boo's out. He's fast.
Yeah, he
got out.
Yeah, when he wants out, he darts.
Oh, he darted like a bat out of hell, Mike.
Yeah.
He found the opportunity.
He won't be out that long. It's cold.
I hope not. Well, that's what I wanted to tell you, because I'm getting ready to go to bed. I've had 3 beers, and I'm tired. Annie took some. Not that many, though. Just all the ones that were in the door.
Gotcha.
Okay, well, I wanted you to know that you had clean sheets to look forward to.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Cool.
And I folded all Zadie's laundry and all Eli's laundry. I even ironed Eli's shirts. My Annie and Zadie took a nap.
We just pulled out of the Helger.
Out of the yard?
Yeah, we're heading home.
Okay. I keep watching to make sure Annie gets home safe. Zadie's gonna sleep.
Yeah, where are they at?
Oh, she's so fun. Looks like they're in Farmington Hills right now. On the freeway.
Gotcha.
Okay, honey. I wanted to tell you that.
All right.
And that I love you.
I love you too.
Another
okay. Long drive home.
I know. I might not make it.
Me either.
You have to. Oh, my back. I've been playing with the baby all day. I came in the garage. I'm finishing my beer, I told you. And pudding's on my lap in front of the heater. And I have the door open and I'm freezing for Boo.
Yeah.
Would he know to push the door open?
I don't know. Probably.
I don't either.
And if it was just barely cracked, you know, where it was closed. But
I know. I tried to do that, but the wind blows it open a little. So. Okay. Love you tons.
All right. Love you.
Bye.
Own a business or manage health benefits, you want to hear this. Hi, this is Randy, and I'm here again with Steve Selinsky, Vice President of Business Development for HAP. Hi, Steve. Hey, Randy. So employers want to control health insurance costs, of course, but they still want to make their employees happy. Have any advice?
Sure. One way to make everyone happy is to offer multiple plan options.
Isn't that just for large businesses, though?
Well, not really. With HAP, even small groups can offer multiple health plan options, giving your employees a choice, from our affordable HMO plans to our PPO plans with national coverage.
So how does that help control costs exactly?
Well, employers can cap their contributions, maybe just enough to pay for the lowest cost plan.
Right.
And then their employees can decide if they want to pay more for additional coverage.
Got it. So how can employers learn more?
They can visit hap.org/business,
okay.
Call their agent, or call our HAP team at 1-833-DIAL-HAP. That's 1-833-DIAL-HAP.
Okay. Thanks, Steve. Appreciate it.
We talk football straight up. Game Day Uncensored starts Sunday morning at 9 on 97.1 The Ticket.
actually that number five, that was late September. No, it wasn't.
No.
The 2.2 miles. Turn left onto Insel 40s toward I-94 West.
You know what's going to happen, though? You know what's going to happen? He's going to end up being not liked and not appreciated by the end of his tenure because of how ugly this is going to get and how bad he's going to look.
I just think that he's not in good shape. He'll understand and just move on. And he'll end his career with the Astros anyhow. Winning World Series for the Astros.
Yeah, not being able to record a hit in the World Series. That's how he'll end his career. What the? Okay.
Yeah, well, hey,
it's out of here.
He just threw Blake Griffin to the floor.
No, don't set that cutout next to me, okay?
Oh my God.
Blake's a terrific talent. I don't need him looking over my shoulder here.
Oh
boy.
Breaking news, Blake Griffin is now out for the season.
Knocked
down to the floor by Kyle Bowen.
Blake Griffin has been entered into concussion protocol by the Detroit Pistons. This statement is released on November 7th. It's November 7th, right?
Yes. How much of a running start would you have to get to be able to push down Blake Griffin?
Oh, there's no way in hell. No way.
You couldn't even do it with a tractor.
No.
Could you?
I mean, I'm just a microphone warrior, man. There's no way.
No. Like, you couldn't even do it with your little toy truck that you drive around.
No. Well.
No, there's no way.
That's bigger than a toy truck, okay?
Sure.
I got a big truck.
Next break, I'm going to pick Blake up. That doesn't look good with him laying down on the floor there.
And the papers fell over his face, too. Did you see that?
Yeah, somebody's going to step on him.
Speaking of the NBA, and we're going to get to a little Lions question. We'll do that coming up in the 7 o'clock hour. Oh, yeah, help him up. Yeah, the poor thing.
Yeah.
What is going on?
He's back.
Okay. We'll get to a Lions thing coming up here in the 7 o'clock hour as Blake Griffin is now over my shoulder, casting a very large shadow over me. But there was a statement that was just released by the NBA, and I don't want to make this an NBA topic, okay?
It's a sports topic. It's interesting.
It really is, okay? So apparently the NBA fined the Clippers for statements that weren't consistent with Kawhi Leonard's health status. Of course, the Clippers have come out and said that, you know, they're not going to play Kawhi Leonard because on back-to-backs because of a lingering knee issue that they need to monitor, and that's a part of their injury protocol or whatever. And I think it's pretty clear he's just doing the load management thing. I don't think there's really an injury.
Yeah.
I think the fact that the NBA actually came out yesterday and, you know, they pointed out some of the knee issues, it's an injury and blah, 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 like defending it, okay? I think it's ridiculous. But even Michael Jordan get asked about Kawhi Leonard and only playing 62 games last year for the Raptors, and it looks like he's going to do the same thing for the Clippers this year. And Jordan's response was, "You're paid to play 82 games."
Mm-hmm.
End quote. Like, very just right to the point, right there at it. Is this a black eye for Kawhi Leonard, of course, number one, as far as his legacy is going to be concerned, but number two, isn't this a black eye on sports right now in general? And these younger athletes and this generation and how they're going to be remembered?
Well, how many do it besides Kawhi Leonard?
The NBA is one
of
the
bigger ones. And they don't do it until they get older, right?
Kawhi is not that old, though.
He's 28, 29. But you're right. He's not. And it doesn't go on in most other sports. Baseball, you know, veteran players don't play a day game after a night game. I get that. Here's why the Clippers, though, I think got in trouble, got fined.
Yeah.
Even though the NBA said, yeah, he has, you know, an injury, is they don't want you to announce he's not going to play the second of back-to-backs. Because that, so then people know going to the arena he's not playing and maybe they wouldn't buy tickets.
Very true.
They want it left open, the chance that he might play. And didn't the Clippers basically announce which days off he has? So that can't be totally injury related at all.
I just think this is completely and totally overblown. Like, look at LeBron James. Okay, you can say whatever you want about LeBron James. He's in his 17th season in the NBA. LeBron has played all the time.
In half a mile, turn left onto Edsall 40s toward I-94 West.
And then he was shut down for the rest of the season, okay? LeBron's done just fine. And he's basically played, what, an extra couple of seasons? as far as the postseason is concerned, because of all the NBA finals that he's gone to. Yes, I know he didn't win all of the NBA finals.
Did he win any of them?
All right, yeah. And Michael Jordan's undefeated in the NBA finals. That's not the discussion here. But, like, plenty of athletes are just fine. You know, and I love the NBA. I do. Okay, I'm going to watch. There's four games on tonight. I can't wait to watch it. But you look at a sport like hockey, 82-game regular season. It's a lot more grueling sport than the NBA, is it not? A lot more physical, a lot more injuries you could potentially deal with.
Yeah.
Things that you have to play through. Football, 16 games. I know they play less games, but you don't see guys necessarily load managing.
No, they do their load management during the week.
Exactly, but they're always out there when it matters.
Turn left onto Insall 40s toward I-94 West. You know, then keep left to merge onto I-94 West.
You know, a veteran might not play day, night, you know, whatever.
Pitchers don't pitch past six innings anymore. Hello, that's load management.
Okay,
there really is, actually.
Does it bother you as a sports fan, though? That this, I don't know, the change that we're seeing where these guys need a mental health day, or, you know, these guys need to monitor their bodies, or, you know, Kawhi Leonard can't play,
not just the NBA.
Exactly. Well, 248-539-9797, ticket text 97136. It bothers me a little bit. I get it, but it does bother me a little bit. But I'm generally not a fan paying money to go to the game, so I, you know, because I cover them.
Yeah.
But I wonder if you're paying to go to the game, if it bothers you a lot.
Keep left.
And as much as people get down on them sometimes, you know who is always available to play? Always. Andre Drummond, always available to play. Like,
in 3 miles, take exit 215B to merge onto Michigan 10 North towards Southfield.
About Stafford and Drummond having similar seasons, career seasons, but not winning seasons. So, do you admire that as a sports fan? Like, he's there every day, or, but you know what? I'd rather see Kawhi Leonard at his best, or whoever at his best. And if that means missing 15 games, fine. I did wonder about that. Remember when we were at the one game that LeBron was going to play at LCA last year with the Lakers, and he bailed right before?
Yeah, and people thought
that was crappy, yeah.
Well, and the ironic thing is he ended up walking out and sitting on the bench, and nobody was watching the game. Everyone was looking at LeBron in his suit and his glasses that he was wearing, sitting over there on the little bench. But, yeah, I mean, that would frustrate me. I mean, if you're traveling to go see a player, or, you know, you're spending money and your kid, you know, wants to see his hero.
In 2 miles, take exit 215B to merge onto Michigan 10 North towards Southfield.
You know, they drive to Cleveland and they want to see a little Steph Curry or something like that, his favorite player. And Curry's like, nah, I'm good tonight. I mean, he would be crushed.
Would you? Right?
Yes. Would you feel better then if the NBA require, if you are doing a quote unquote load management, if they required you to, and to let people know a day or two before?
Stay in the left 3 lanes.
You bring up a good point about ticket sales, and they want the allure of, you know, a guy being there. I mean, they don't even come out with their injury reports a lot of times until 6:30, the final ones leading up to the game.
See, and this is a ticket text 97136. That this has also been debated, I see, on the talking head shows during the day on the little TVs.
Mm-hmm.
And this has become a big issue. Ticket text. That is why Kawhi Leonard should never be mentioned as an all-time great.
And he'll never, he won't be.
A lot of people are now suggesting that. And I don't know. Is it just the new normal, and you won't even think of him as being unusual as more players do it? Or is it ridiculous if that becomes the new normal?
See, and I think that's it right there. I think this frustrates people. Like, if there's other athletes who just go balls to the wall and continue to get it done, and they're out there and they're healthy and they're fine, why can't he do the same?
Would that hurt, though?
No, not really. By the way, Doc Rivers.
Use the right lane to take exit 215 to merge onto Michigan 10 North towards Southfield.
97. This load management, athletes taking games off, can't play on a back-to-back. Does it affect how you view it? Does it affect you as a fan and rooting for these guys and their legacy down the line? 97 won the ticket.
97 won the ticket. Traffic.
This report brought to you by the San Francisco Law.
Take the exit.
Sam, there's planned overnight road work scheduled for 94 westbound from 696 to 8 Mile. Only the left lane open, 8 o'clock tonight through 5 a.m. You'll find the entrance and exit ramps will be closed within the zone. Another project for overnight, 94 eastbound from Rotunda to Michigan Avenue and Dearborn. lane closure 9 to 9 through tomorrow morning. And there's a work zone in place through Saturday morning at complete closure of Utica Road southbound to south of 15 Mile in Fraser. I'm Michelle Pena, the WWJ 24-hour traffic center.
Stay in the left 3 lanes.
I'm Attorney Mark Bernstein. When you need help, you turn to family. Every day we fight for families like yours because we are family.
1-800-CALL-SAM.
Get all the perks with the Planet Fitness Black Card for no enrollment fee. That means every time you thought,
I haven't had the motivation to work out,
you can bring a friend. Or,
I really need a massage,
you can get one. And you can work out at any Planet Fitness worldwide.
Oh, a Planet Fitness.
No enrollment fee. $22.99 a month to get all the perks. Join in club or at planetfitness.com. Join today at any of the 47 Detroit area Planet Fitness locations or go online at planetfitness.com. Hurry, offer ends soon. Annual membership fee applies. Participating locations only. See club for details.
What? I plan to stop smoking, so I lost my train of thought.
No worries.
Most don't get it on the first try, but if you keep trying to quit smoking, you can succeed.
Thank you.
I plan to stop smoking, so I keep my hands busy when I have the urge to smoke. Like, I play with pencils, and I've broken a bunch. But hey, if it helps me break this addiction, it's worth it. Get tips to help you quit at everytrycounts.gov.
Attention new car buyers, Parkway Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram is kicking off the holiday season with a spectacular 3-day sale. Starting now through Monday till 9 p.m., offering employee plus pricing for everyone. Our entire inventory of over 2,000 new vehicles. Parkway's offering incredible lease deals on new Ram 1500 pickups, Jeep Grand Cherokees, Cherokees, and Compass. Parkway's accepting offers on all remaining 2018 models and giant savings on our selection of demos. With employee plus pricing for everyone, we have hundreds of vehicles for under $200 a month. Parkway will get you out of any lease with a $3,000 or less payoff. Parkway offers more trade-in cash, $2,000 more. The appraised value plus an extra $2,000. Parkway will buy your vehicle even if we don't sell you a new one. See George Hale, buy it for cash. That's employee pricing plus for everyone during the Black Friday sales event. Buy now only at Parkway Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram on Hall Road in Clinton Township. Show up, sign up. Saturday 10 to 3, see the details at ParkwayCBJ.com.
24/7. Time for another Action Network Flash. Tonight, Oakland hosts the AFC's Los Angeles team, and the road team is a 2-point favorite. Over 60% of the spread tickets are on LA. For all the betting info, download the free Action Network app today.
This hour of instant feedback brought to you by Whitey Pearl National Benefit Plan. For affordable health insurance, log on to NBPHealth.com.
See amazing career comfort garage sales tomorrow 9 to 6 and Saturday 9 to 4. Get free Tigers gear, including jerseys, jackets, kids apparel, autographs, memorabilia, and more. Prices start at just $1 with free parking in the Tiger Garage. Details at tigers.com/garage sale.
WXYT FM and WXYT HD1 Detroit. The radio.com sports station.
Still.
show right now on the Golf Channel. He goes to Tony Finau, Patrick Reed, Gary Woodland, the U.S. Open champion, and Tiger Woods picks himself. Tiger Eldrick Woods, a captain's pick. He selects himself. He's going to play in the President's Cup coming up in December.
How about that?
Stay in the left three lanes.
Out there on the market right now, okay? Hall Financial, they're not this, you know, massive terrible raid and not take care of you, not find out about your professional and personal situation. No, they want to get to know you. You know, Dee Hall and his team over at Hall Financial, they're going to give you the best care. They're going to answer every question that you have, make you feel totally comfortable with the home buying process. They did it for me. They just recently did it for Sully, who purchased his first home. If you want to find out why Hall Financial has almost 1,000 five-star reviews, simply pick up the phone and call them today, 248-308-5000, or you can go online, chat with a mortgage expert at davidhallmortgage.com.
Need care now? With the Henry Ford Urgent Care Skill for Amazon Alexa, you can now ask Alexa for urgent care in walk-in clinic locations, hours, and wait times. Learn more at henryford.com/Alexa.
If you want it, you can get it.
Turn right onto Inkster Road.
Okay. Respect needs to be earned if you want to be superior.
There's only one superior. And that's Superior Buick GMC in Dearborn. We earn our customers' respect every day through superior price, superior inventory, and we're a 2019 J.D. Power dealer.
In 1.4 miles, turn left onto West 14-mile road.
Is important to you. Maybe you should consider a dealer that's a 2019 J.D. Power dealer of excellence. And there's more. Right now, mention you want your Gator deal, and you can lease a brand new Buick Encore Preferred with all-wheel drive for only $149 a month with $14.95 down. How's that for a superior lease? Only $149 a month for a brand new 2019 Buick Encore Preferred.
For details, visit Superior Buick GMC on Michigan Avenue, just east of Greenfield. Or shop online, we deliver at superioronline.com.
For J.D. Power 2019 DOE information, visit jdpower.com/DOE.
To the many military members in our Detroit community, we honor your dedicated service and duty to our country.
In 1 mile, turn left onto West 14-mile road.
We are grateful for your sacrifice, bravery, and skill. Thank you. This message of honor and gratitude is locally sponsored by WOW Internet, TV, and Phone. Proud to support Detroit area military members and veterans through employment, special offers, and community sponsorship. To learn more about WOW in Detroit, go to wowway.com.
Introducing Del Mar, Detroit's newest destination for watching sports. Located in the heart of Greektown at the corner of Monroe and Bobian, Del Mar's Scratch Kitchen has a diverse menu of favorites to enjoy while watching the game. Craft beer, wine, spirits, and cocktails all flow from behind the huge 360-degree bar. Before, during, or after the game, there is no sports experience like the Del Mar Detroit experience. The brand new Del Mar Detroit is open now. Find Del Mar Detroit on Facebook or go to delmardetroit.com.
Do you know who really loves fresh food? Amateur chefs, barbecuers, smorgasborders, snackers, bakers, and thrown in the microwavers. At Kroger, you can get all the fresh you want at great price with delivery and free pickup because we believe in fresh for everyone.
Red, white, or black seedless grapes are just 97 cents a pound with card. Order for delivery or free pickup today. Restrictions apply. Kroger, fresh for everyone.
If it matters on game day, it's on Game Day Uncensored. Pat Caputo and Mike Stone preview all the important matchups. Mike Valenti gives you the real story right up to game time. Brought to you by Power Home Solar, Rinaldi Sausage, and Comerica Bank. Sundays on 97.1 The Ticket. Text 97.1 The Ticket now at 97136. Ticket text brought to you by LaFontaineFamilyDealDirect.com. Find the perfect car. Customize your monthly payment.
Turn left onto West 14-mile road, then turn right onto Inkster Road.
.com.
97.1 The Ticket and Allison Brewery have teamed up. Introducing the Ticket American Lager and the Ticket Double Dry Hopped Hazy Pale Ale. Look for them on draft at a bar or restaurant near you.
Turn right onto Inkster Road.
Practice his own load management. We were talking about
in 1.3 miles, arrive at Inkster Road.
Stretching his bag.
Oh, there we go. And you know, I guess I'm not surprised. I didn't think it was that big of a deal that, you know, Kawhi Leonard would miss whatever 10, 15 games that led to a title. But looking at the ticket text, it really does piss people off. And, 248-539-9797, ticket text 97136.
In 1 mile, arrive at Inkster Road.
Long, considering the regular season and playoff schedules. In my opinion, the playoffs are what drives this league. So what would you rather have? A great season record or a playoff run minus your big guns? That's from our big gun buddy, Paul and Shelby.
See, I get why they do it. I mean, obviously it worked for the Raptors, but, you know, we always debate and talk about legacy and, you know, where are you going to be held in that regard? I think this is all going to be held against Kawhi Leonard. I do. Like, every other guy.
Pass.
I don't know.
Hey, Hatchet, can you have my favorite little soundbite ready? The tinkle, tinkle, the...
Tinkle, tinkle.
No, you know that, because I want to read this ticket text. Hey, Wojo, are you practicing load management when you don't do any show prep, or are you working on a, quote, deadline?
Oh.
Cue the sound of a GMT. Yeah.
There. From what I understand, all of your best columns are written while in the tank. I don't know.
Never. I'm always working on a column. Here's the problem, real quick, because, you know, it gets made fun of, Joe, to come in late, but it usually, almost always, that's what I'm working on a column. And
yeah.
The problem with the writing process, Bogey, you've written before.
It's awful.
Arrive at Inkster Road.
It can take
arrived.
Longer than you think or not.
Yeah.
There's no way. It's not like a precise process.
Mm-hmm.
You know, sometimes you have to sit there and think and stir the drink a little bit and then think some more.
Oh, I always know when you're deep in the bottom. I mean, deep in your column. It's when you don't respond to text messages.
No, I go dark.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Zero dark mojo.
No, I go dark.
That's what it is. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And then I read the column and I go, did he really spend a whole lot of time on this? Like,
wow, that's a great story.
It's a solid 20 minutes.
He had to go rogue to write that, you know, Brady Hoke liked to spend time at Wings Pizza and things and make a joke?
No, Brady Hoke liked to eat the samples at Costco. He did.
Of course he did.
He told that story.
Can I get another one? Give me a multiply and consecutively. Give me one of those little quesadillas.
Let's talk to Pat and Troy. You're on 97 on the ticket. What's up, Pat?
Hey, got a little different angle from it than other people are talking. This whole thing of the load management stuff. As a Pistons fan, I feel like I bear the brunt and the burden of this more than other fans. These people are, all the teams want to have a great record, but who are they going to sit out against? Are they going to sit out against the Pistons? Or are they going to sit out against Philadelphia or Boston?
You're right.
So we, as fans, don't have the opportunity, potentially, to see all the greats play the game.
You know, you're right about that. That's only natural if you're one of the, a good player to sit out against a crappy team, right? They could probably win
right
now.
How dare you call the Pistons crappy?
No, in general, Pistons are 4-5. They're almost at 500.
Yeah.
No, I get that. And Pat, you're right. If you go to Pistons games, you probably suffer more than the average guy.
Well, yeah. And I don't know that, shouldn't the league do something about it that, you know, the team, because of, you know, we're not as strong as the other teams, that we don't get to see the great players? It's all about the fans.
Yeah.
Shouldn't it be?
Well, okay. The flip side is, though, if Kawhi Leonard's not playing, you probably have a better chance of winning the game.
Sure. Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Like they did when Toronto came here. Right? Although I think Kawhi played in that one or he didn't play that, whatever.
Well, you know, the Pistons were undefeated against the Raptors last year. So, you know, they were just lucky.
You beat the best, you are the best.
You gotta beat the man. Or wait. Mm. You gotta be the man to beat the man.
Yeah, whatever.
Is that what it is, Rick Flair said? Yeah, that's the quote.
Mm.
You gotta be the man to beat the man or something like that. Yeah.
What about this? And I didn't think about this, but Hatchet can chime in on this. I wonder if there's a couple, with everybody ripping on it and saying, oh, soccer doesn't have it. Oh, but ticket text. Oh, your white baby boomer audience is crotchety about something. Who knew? That is something picking on the NBA, but defending the NHL and baseball. And I don't think that's what it is. The NBA is where it's most afflicted.
No! Yeah, that's where it's happening.
But I'm not surprised that somebody would dig deeper in that. Soccer, you know. Soccer has the second most injuries behind football. The average soccer player runs an average of 8 miles a game. Okay.
You do have to be in peak physical condition.
Okay.
I was a soccer player growing up.
You show me the evidence
that there are more serious injuries in soccer than there are in football.
Well,
oh no, he said second behind football.
Define okay. serious okay,
second,
though.
Second behind football. He said second. I'll cut him up side.
Define serious. I think there's more injuries.
There's probably more pulled muscles and stuff because you're always running.
Yeah.
But
I was a soccer player my entire life, and then I didn't play from like 18 to 23, and then I joined a rec team, you know, just a beer league or whatever, playing with some buddies and all that. I played midfield. So you're just running the whole freaking game up and down the side. I almost died. I swear to God. Oh my God. It is so much.
You didn't get touched by another human.
Well, yeah. I took a lot of physical pounding. A lot of slide tackles into the shin guard.
Yeah, well, that's true.
My shin!
Ow!
Don't do that.
Let's see if you get this reference from Danny in a car. Okay, I hope Brady Hoke used the folktale stick sampling stuff. The commercial with Chef Ramsay. Use the folktale stick.
I don't know that I've seen that.
Oh, yeah.
It's wait, Chef Ramsay or Chef Emerald?
Chef Ramsay, right?
Oh.
Yeah.
Who's Chef Ramsay?
It was a chef named Ramsay.
Is it TV? Is he like famous or something?
Yes!
Oh, is he the Hell's Kitchen guy?
Yes!
Oh, okay.
Or whatever
okay.
that one, yeah.
Yeah, whatever it was. Yeah.
Was that everybody makes everybody cry?
Yeah, yeah. And speaking of a guy who needs load management, take a day off, man. Let's talk to Barry in Royal Oak. You're on 97.1 to take it. Hey, Barry.
Hey, guys. You know, kind of with the point the last caller made, if I was a TV exec, I know a couple years ago they started sitting out like on the Saturday night games, the national TV games, and that would drive me crazy if I was ESPN after all the money they've paid him.
Yeah.
But I mean, if you're a Clipper fan, the benefit of Kawhi sitting out some games is that he's going to go further in the playoffs. They're the only ones that are going to get the benefit from it. They should not sit him like if on any of the East Coast games. They come to town once a year. You know what I mean? He comes
yeah,
from Detroit.
I agree.
That just drives me crazy. If you want to sit him at a home game where your fans are going to get the benefit later on, they need to do something about this. The NBA was built on stars. Larry Bird, Magic Johnson, they don't wear helmets. That's how it was built. I know we like to think of the team game, but the NBA was built on star power. And I think they're messed around and they might be a little, I don't know, man. I think they're going down a wrong road. Okay. You want to sit them at home.
Well, Barry,
they never will, though. I don't think they ever do they? Do they do load management at home? Maybe if they're in a long home stand.
Yesterday was a home game.
Yeah, it was a home game for the Clippers
okay.
last night.
Okay, so he did do it. All
yeah,
right.
The over hit. It was great. Fantastic evening. No, but the thing for me is, too, and this is what I think the NBA is most pissed off about, they're clearly allowing the Clippers and Kawhi Leonard to just do this. Who's to say Giannis doesn't start doing this? Who's to say not Mike Conley's not that high, but he's an older player.
Kennard
could start doing it. Andre Drummond could start doing it. Like, all of these stars, and then all of a sudden you have, like, one or two guys on every team doing this load management thing, and your big games on national TV are rendered useless.
Well, see, that's why it's good that there's a backlash to this. Because Kawhi Leonard is one of these, does his own thing, doesn't care if people rip, doesn't care what people think. But other, like LeBron, couldn't stand the scrutiny probably if somebody ripped on him. And the other thing, the caller is right. The league is, he couldn't.
Any chance to attack LeBron.
He would go crazy if people were calling him a wuss and stuff. But you thank you.
LeBron go crazy.
Go cray-cray. So, but the caller is right. The league has been built on stars and, you know, the matchups. But that has evolved, too, to the point that the league is now built on the postseason, which is longer than ever.
Yeah.
And that is the idea behind load management, is to have them all ready for the postseason.
Mm-hmm.
Like how often in January or February is it a must-watch Sunday afternoon NBA game that everybody... For a normal person, not you. Not a normal person, not you.
Stop it.
Please.
It's good stuff. It's just entertaining, you know? It's something to watch. If you don't want to watch Breaking Bad again, or, you know, a replay of Friends or something.
Ticket text 97136. Soccer players don't drink in beer leagues, Bogey. Don't you mean you were in a White Claw soccer?
Oh, okay. White Claws were not around 10 years ago when I was in my early
spritzer.
20s, okay?
You were in a wine spritzer league.
Yeah.
The guys got together for a wine spritzer game.
We would sit there and have high tea at halftime.
Who brought the crackers and cheese today? Who was in charge?
Coming up in the second half, we got Orange Slice.
That wasn't very good. Yeah. All right, we'll get to this.
Find a stripper voice with Orange Slice.
We'll get to the Lions coming up here. And again, seriously, if you want to break down the captain's picks for the President's Cup, we can do that as well. 97 won the ticket.
Each with promote employee list, all work days to do it.
Galliano's Van Dyke Dodge announces employee pricing to everyone. Our Black Friday sales event is going on now. Why wait? Now everybody pays the same incredible low factory employee price for new Rams and Dodges. No negotiation needed. But only Galliano's Van Dyke Dodge has employee prices plus. Yes, plus. You keep all rebates. Plus, you get a huge 55-inch smart TV with every purchase. Drive the all-new 2020 model Ram 1500 Bighorn 4x4. Not a leftover, but a factory fresh 2020 is back. Two for $222 and 40 to choose from. You heard right. Lease two 2020 Ram 1500 Bighorn 4x4s from just $222. Think you see a lower price? Clip it or click it. And Galliano will beat it by $400 or more. Now every ad is a Van Dyke Dodge ad. See Galliano's Van Dyke Dodge in Warren. Because if you want employee prices and a whole lot more.
The internet. You need it. Almost every minute of the day. Because, hey, you got shows to stream, emails to reply all to, and LOLs to, LOL. That's why you need Xfinity. You can get the fastest, most reliable internet with gig speeds available. So you can get online and get down to business faster. And Xfinity delivers enhanced network security so all your connected devices are protected. Get instant alerts when strangers are trying to hop on your network. Set curfews with parental controls and pause your Wi-Fi at dinner time. That's life with Xfinity, the best internet provider in America, according to speedtest.net. Now that's simple, easy, awesome. Get started with Xfinity Internet for $20 a month for 12 months with a one-year agreement. Or get four times the speed for just $10 more a month for 12 months. Plus, add enhanced network security. Go online, call 1-800-XFINITY or visit a store today. Requires single bill and auto pay. Ends 1-7-20. Restrictions apply. New performance start at 25 megabits per second. Internet customers only. Equipment, taxes, and fees extra and subject to change. After term, regular rates apply. Actual speeds vary and are not guaranteed.
With fall sports in full swing for student athletes, OK Orthopedics should be your first call after an injury. If you're experiencing pain, there are alternatives to surgery. Dr. Letterman and Dr. Korowitz are fellowship-trained, board-certified surgeons who use surgery as a last resort, with 80 to 90% of patients successfully avoiding surgery. Visit the physical therapy clinic inside OK Orthopedics. Tell them Jamie from 97 won the ticket sent you, and they guarantee an appointment the next business day. LKOrthopedics.com.
It's no crime to love true crime. In fact, you're not alone with your fascination for murder and mayhem. That's why the Radio.com app has a wide range of true crime at your fingertips. Like the popular podcasts Up and Vanished, The Clearing, Most Notorious, Southern Fried True Crime, and so much more. All available 24/7 and all just a click away. When it comes to true crime, Radio.com has it locked up. Radio.com on your desktop or download the free app now.
You don't have to listen to me. You can just change the station. It's completely within your control. Your personal information, well, that's another story. When you shop, bank, or browse online, your info travels all over, exposing you to cyber threats, which are out of your control. More threats demand more protection. That's why Norton and LifeLock are now part of one company. Norton 360 with LifeLock provides all-in-one membership for your cyber safety that gives you device security, identity theft protection, a VPN for online privacy, and more. No one can prevent all cybercrime and identity theft, but Norton 360 with LifeLock is your ally in today's connected world. Sign up today for Norton 360 with LifeLock. And since you did choose to listen, save 25% or more off your first year by going to Norton.com/news. That's Norton.com/news for 25% off.
Jets is Detroit-style pizza, baked to the thickest crunch in steel pans inspired by the Motor City. Want Detroit-style proof? Get their large, perfectly paired pepperoni pizza, bold and traditional, just $12.99. Jets, better because it has to be.
The only way you can take 97 won the ticket with you is the Radio.com app. Download it today and listen to us anytime, anywhere. Brought to you by the LaFontaine Automotive Group, the family deal.
Ticket.
Trubisky and the Chicago Bears.
Yeah, that's all he's worth, a dollar or two. Throw it on this state. Boy, he is getting destroyed.
Yeah, Chicago right now.
He really is.
Honestly, I don't think anyone would throw a dollar bill at him right now.
No.
Bogey Mojo, 97 on the ticket. Might as well transition that into a little Lions discussion. And it's interesting because we talked about Matt Patricia and where this team is at. And yesterday, I think we had the discussion about, you know, how are you going to approach these final eight games? They're 3-4-1. Do you want to see him make a run? Do you want to see him implode? Blah, 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 right? This is one of those games, though, where, like, if there's a teeter-totter, okay? And say, you know, one end is a vote of confidence potentially for Matt Patricia if they can win this game and shut down Mitch Trubisky and the Chicago Bears. It goes up a little bit, right? Whereas if Mitch Trubisky is able to beat you and put up like 21, 25, 30 points, something like that, that would represent I don't want to say a breaking point, like, that's it, he's over, it should be fired. But wouldn't a loss Sunday or a situation where Stafford has to go out there and put up 35 points and you win 35-31 because your defense still stands
a win,
wouldn't that be, how did you phrase it in the pre-show, the beginning of the end, if you will, with Matt Patricia?
A tipping point for a lot of people regards Patricia and his defensive acumen, for sure. I mean, some people look, I probably already get that tipping point. We are at the halfway point of the season.
Right here, I have.
I get that. But you know what's going to happen is the Lions are going to win Sunday. They are going to shut down Mitchell Trubisky. And everyone's going to yell at, well, what did they do? All they did was they beat Mitch Trubisky. He's terrible. Okay, that's
right here.
Right. That's probably accurate. But the alternative is so horrible that if their defense gets beaten by this guy.
Do you really think they're winning?
Yeah, I do.
Really?
I've been pretty on the money. I had them losing to Oakland. I had them beating the Giants. Nobody thought they'd beat the Giants. I forget the game before that. You know, but just to make you a little bit nervous, the game in Chicago last year with the Lions, he beat them up pretty good, Trubisky. Remember he ran quite a bit?
Mm-hmm.
I think the Bears won 34-22.
Plus, it's Matthew Stafford outside.
Yeah.
We know he's more of a dome guy or a warm weather guy.
He's an anywhere guy this year.
Uh-huh.
No, that would be... Again, I don't know if it's... they'd be... If they lose to Mitch Trubisky and the Bears, when they're in turmoil, like... This is the last game for Trubisky. I think if he has a terrible game, they're going to bench him and go to Chase Daniel.
I don't buy that.
I do. I totally do. Because he's probably losing the locker room. Nagy, if the Bears lose, they've been 3-6. Just like here, we say the Lions don't waste a great year by Stafford. The Bears will be wasting a very good defense, although not as great as it was supposed to be. Oh, yeah. I would be very careful.
All right, the phone number is 248-539-9797. Ticket text is at 97136. We know how bad the Bears have been. We know how bad the Lions' defense has been. Mitch Trubisky is not a good quarterback. If the Lions go to Chicago and Mitch Trubisky looks decent and the Lions lose this game to the Bears, does that represent the beginning of the end of any hope that Matt Patricia is the right guy for the job? The phone number is 248-539-9797. Of course, ticket text is at 97136.
Now, if Matt Patricia ever wants to ask me, a veteran voice here in the city of Detroit, for advice, I would say don't lose this game. Don't lose this one.
Okay.
Because the Bears also are a sore spot for Lions fans in general. But the game last year in Chicago, it was November 11th. Oh, my God. What is it going to be this Sunday? Is that November 11th? 8th?
No.
10th.
10th.
Maybe 10th. It was November 11th. The Bears won 34-22. Trubisky was 23 for 30 for 355 yards, 3 touchdowns, no interceptions, and he also ran for 18 yards. Holy, and scored a touchdown with him on one of those runs. He was fabulous against them last year. That can't happen again, can it?
Oh, but it can. This defense is not good. honestly, I think if the Lions are able to go out there and shut Trubisky down, won't it be because Matt Patricia changed his ways and changed his scheme and got more aggressive and sent other blitz packages?
Or it might just because Trubisky stinks.
Possibly, yeah. But I do think that in order for this defense to actually improve and get these guys to buy in and want to play in this defense, because I think there's a lot of players, Darius Slay, that don't want to play in this non-aggressive, you know, lame defense, I think you have to amp that up a little bit.
I guess.
I mean, I don't buy that they're going to, though. I feel like he's going to go out there with a different game plan, but the same approach, scheme.
I mean, I understand, but if you're a good coach, I don't buy that the great coaches just have a system and they teach it to the great. No. I think the great coaches adapt. They adapt to the opponent. They adapt to the players on your roster.
Mm-hmm.
If guys aren't quite what you thought they were, you have to. Bill Belichick, the Patriots morph into something different every single week, offensively and defensively. So if Patricia doesn't adapt and just sticks to, then that makes me think he's not a good coach. If he doesn't adapt.
If this thing comes off the rails, they lose to the Bears. They only win a few more games the rest of this season.
They're not losing to the Bears.
The Bears are a good team.
The Bears.
Do you think there's even a chance that Patricia gets fired? And I'm not talking about, like, they lose every game here on out. And they finish 3-9-1, or no, not 3-9-1, 3-12-1, or whatever it would be.
You're not saying that's
quick math. No. Like, that would be the extreme. Yes, if they finish 3-12.